worshipped his older cousin Charles Darwin. And he said that the selection of the fittest meant he's effectively was one of the key people who created social Darwinism, which I don't think Charles Darwin would have himself embraced at all, which was the idea that rich people are rich because they're genetically superior to poor people, which is
nonsense.
At the same time, commonly held amongst capitalists. And this is, in a sense, part of capitalism and capitalist theory.
Okay. You say you have some proof, and you know, I'm sure plenty of people would know what that proof is. But ultimately, wouldn't you be an advocate of saying that this kind of behaviour is cultural, and it has been cultural for a very long time?
Cultural.
Been cultural for a long time, and there is a shift. So in other words, we've gone through phases, and different communities have gone from having, you know, women in a dominant place to being in a totally subservient place, and the meeting of whites and the fear of whites in not knowing or not understanding who these people are, and in that, not that I'm saying that it's okay, but that is changing, and it is a cultural thing. So no matter how much evidence you supply, it's going to continue to exist until eventually changing somewhere along the line.
Well, the way I'm looking at this is that when you're talking about an organized campaign and strategy of genocide, we're not talking about something that has happened throughout the ages. We're talking about a relatively recent phenomenon. And we're talking about race-based killing of millions of people, as did the Nazis. And if AIDS, this is the point, is that if AIDS is the product of race-based genocide, it is a worse crime against humanity than what the Nazis perpetrated against the Jewish people and the Russians and the Poles and the 10 million or so people who were killed, which was in the gypsies and Semitic races, as they call them.
Yeah.
And the thing is that the Nazis at the same time also had an edict of mass murder in German Southwest Africa. And there was a big competition between the German Nazis and the British imperialists for exploitation of Southern Africa. Cecil Rhodes, and you know, after whom the Rhodes Scholarship is named, had a vision of opening up Africa from Cape to Cairo, from South Africa to Egypt.
Yeah.
And his idea was based on trying to get gold and diamonds, but particularly diamonds, because of course we're talking about the world's richest sources of diamonds. Yeah. Now, what I, when I went and researched eugenics and looking particularly really at white supremacy, extremism, needless to say, focuses of these were in academic institutions in what were the white British colonies, right? And noting that most British colonies were not white colonies. However, we're talking about Canada, New Zealand, Australia, and South Africa.
Right.
And these were the countries that really embraced eugenics theories because it was validating their idea that they were intellectually superior to the people who they were ruling.
Who were the people who were indigenous to?
Who were indigenous to the area.
Your indigenous, your Maoris, your Aboriginals.
Exactly.
And so forth.
So it's fear? Is it fear that the white Americans want to dominate the world and wipe out populations because they're frightened of who they are, because they're black or different shape or different look? Or why do they want to control?
Yes, well, ultimately I'd say yes, it is fear. It's fear of overpopulation. And when anyone puts up this forward of this concept of overpopulation, I would always be reminded as to who they think that they are, who are overpopulating. And when they want to have big families themselves, but they don't want other people to have big families. Ultimately, the people who have been crying overpopulation is a bigger threat than nuclear war. They have all been white Americans, and basically white American men, who have developed all these ideas that they are going to get swamped by millions and millions or billions of hungry black people. And they think that those hungry black people are going to become desperate and violent and terrorists. the war on terrorism is, you could say, the newest facet of this concept of the other, you know, the other that is out to get the American way of life. And ultimately, I don't believe that most Americans are racist in that way. We're talking about a racist government. And I don't think you have to look very far to find that the American government is deeply racist. Even all the statistics that they compile are based on blacks, whites, and Hispanics.
So they tell their own to have plenty of big families, but they'll kill off the rest of the world community that they don't like or they believe doesn't agree with them and their philosophy.
Exactly. And you know, ultimately it's capitalists who have developed this, and they don't want people who are not capitalists. And so if people don't fit into the system, they'll find various ways of killing them or neutering them or sterilizing them or locking them up. And I see the private prison system as another facet of that. And that brings me to something that I wanted to discuss with you, which was about Andrew Denton's